Hello everyone, when you want to create and link complex animations in After Effects, but want to avoid creating dozens or hundreds of keyframes by hand, try using expressions. But first of all, you should know what expression is in After Effects and what it is used for. Expressions are small pieces of JavaScript code that we can add to animated layers and features in our After Effects projects. Therefore, using expressions saves time, and in many cases, we no longer need to create multiple keyframes in the timeline. Now I want to add some vibration to this video using an expression. If I hit the play button, you can see that the camera movement has no shake, so I will add some shake to the camera. To do this, I click on the video layer and press the P key on the keyboard until the position appears. Now, holding the Alt button, I click on the stopwatch next to the position. In this way, the color of these numbers becomes red, and in this box we can add the desired expression for this layer. Another way to add an expression to the layer is to click on the position and select Add Expression from the animation menu. You can also use the shortcut Alt plus Shift plus equals. Therefore, by choosing this option again, we can add an expression to the layer and position. The expression that I want to add for this layer is called Wiggle. So I delete this text and type Wiggle. I double-click on the Wiggle to add it to the layer. Now we have to type two numbers inside the parentheses. The first number determines the number of vibration repetitions per second, which I write as 5. Then I add a comma and type 10 for the second number, which determines the displacement of the pixels. Now if I press the play button, we can see the camera shaking. We see that the edges of the image become black due to the movement of the camera. To correct this issue, I hold the Shift button and make the video larger by holding the left click and dragging. Now I select the Fit option and press the Play button. We can see that the edges of the image have been modified. This time I increased the number of wiggles. I set the first number as 6 and the second number as 13. Now if I press the play button, we can see that the video shakes more. The more we increase the wiggle numbers, the more the image shake will increase. Now I am going to create another expression in a new composition. I've already inserted an image of a gear into the timeline, and I also draw a circle with the shape tool. Now I am going to connect the rotation of this gear to the position of this circle. Actually, I want the gear wheel to start rotating by moving the circle. To do this, I first select the gear layer and press the R button to bring up the rotation option. Now I click on the rotation and select Add Expression from the animation menu. In this way, we can add a new expression to the layer. Here there is a button called Expression Pick Whip, which we can use to connect rotation or other transform options to the parameters of another layer. Now I select the shape layer and press the P key on the keyboard so that the position appears. Using the expression Pick Whip tool and holding down the left click, I connect the rotation of the gear layer to the y-axis of the circle position. In this box, we see that After Effects automatically creates an expression. Now, by moving the circle in the y-axis, the gear starts to rotate. If we move the circle in the x-axis, the gear will not rotate because we only connected the y-axis of the circle position to the rotation of the gear layer. So, just by going up and down the circle, the gear rotates, and we did this without creating a keyframe. There is another option here called Expression Language Menu. If I click on it, we can find different expressions from this section and use them in projects. Also, by using this option, you can disable the expression temporarily, and if you click it again, the expression will be activated. This option is also to show the graph in the timeline, which I taught you about using graphs in the previous lessons. The next point is that we can also define expressions for effects. For example, I click on the gear layer and apply the hue saturation effect. I press the colorize button. In this way, the color of the gear will change, and by changing the hue value, the color of the gear will also change. Now I click on the gear layer and press the E button to reveal the hue saturation effect. I open this effect and click on Colorize Hue. And I choose Add Expression from the Animation menu. Now an expression will appear in the timeline. I hold the left key on the expression pick whip and connect it to the x-axis position of the circle layer. As a result, if I move the circle in the x-axis, the color of the gear will also change. If we move the circle in both the x and y-axis, the gear rotates and its color changes. Now I create an animation for this circle. So I select the circle layer and move the circle to the top. I click on the position stopwatch to create a keyframe at the first second. I set the time indicator to the sixth second and move the circle down. I hit the play button to see the animation. As a result, with the movement of the circle, the gear rotates and its color changes. The last point is that there are many expressions that we can use in different projects of calls to prayer. In the next lesson, I will try to introduce you to important and useful expressions and also teach you how to use them. Well, friends, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please like the video and subscribe to watch more tutorials. See you next time.